Guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. My name's Chris, and if you're new here, I just make dumb shit on video for YouTube. That's what I do. But hey, today we're doing a pressure test on my BMW 335i. Let me turn the camera around. So guys, little story about this car. I was driving down the street one day, and it went into limp mode. Took it to a shop that I trusted because they've done all my work before. This shop is located in Boring, Oregon, and they work on BMWs. Not gonna say the name of them just because I don't want to get sued. But they had my car for 3 weeks and they told me they couldn't pull any codes, which I already knew was a lie. Then they said they reset the timing 3 times, but the issue with the car is how the cam gears, Vandals gears attached to the camshafts that was worn out. And every time the car would run or get under boost, the cam gears would slip camshafts and cause it to go out of time. This shop charged me $600, told me it cost over $5,000 to fix, and after all the towing, I spent about $800. So, you know, I'm not crying or bitching. It is what it is. You know, the shop that
I went to religiously with my BMWs burned me, and burning my relationship was worth $600 to him, and that's cool. That's all right. I made the money back in my business. But I had my buddy Roman come over. He has a BMW scan tool. He hooked it up, cleared the codes, and the car started and didn't go back into limp mode. Now the car still has an issue, so we're gonna smoke test the engine, see if we can find a vacuum leak, and let's do it. Let's videotape it.
All right, guys. So the smoke tester is hooked on to inlet pipe. We'll go ahead and pressure up the system. Now, if you're wondering, this is the smoker smoke products. It's a stinger system. It's a stinger system, and what it does is it burns mineral oil and creates smoke. Runs off an air compressor. Runs at about 10 psi, I believe, or maybe 5. I don't remember. It's been a long time since I've actually had to use it. But let's see. Okay, look, here we go. Now that smoke is coming out of the intake here. Okay, so we know that it's coming out of the intake, so that's fine. Dude, imagine driving down the road and your shit's doing that, but like at nighttime at a show or some, okay, you'd have everyone saying your BMW is a piece of shit, it broke down. Most likely it probably did, but okay, so that's okay, it's smoking, it's, what we're looking for is another leak somewhere. So here we go, right there at the intake pipe is a leak. And what it's doing is it's throwing some codes. Is it? Yeah, I could see it leaking at the seam. Let's just go and turn it off. I don't know if the camera's gonna catch it, but let's see. See, I'm pretty sure you shouldn't have an intake leak there. So I'm gonna have to take this top part off and see why it's leaking there. You can still see it ever so slightly smoking out the right here, and it shouldn't be doing that.
All right, guys. Well, now we know what we need to fix. I may or may not record the process, but if I find something good, I'll record that, post it up. Alright guys, we're back. What we did was we removed the hose, the clamp, and what they did was they had the rubber part like buckled inside of the hard plastic, and then they clamped it so it had a huge ass vacuum leak past the airflow sensor, mass airflow pressure sensor. So we're repressure testing it, so let's watch it.
So no more leaking there where we had a huge leak. It looks like it's all coming out of the intake, which is fine. What we're actually doing is pressure testing it here where the hard pipe is. This is an upgraded hard pipe because the plastic one broke, and it has a little Allen plug in there you can remove. We have a little leak down there, and I'm thinking it's
probably from the airbox. Let's see. Yeah, there's a little hole under the airbox. Might be for a water drain. And that hole doesn't really matter because the air still gets filtered as it goes past the sensor here, through here, down the pipe, right? Down there into the turbo. Then the turbo side down through the intercooler, up into the engine. I guess that's how it works. I'm just making shit up, but that's all right. Right now we just have the regular leak from the intake, so we're gonna go and turn this off. We're gonna start it up and see how she runs. Watching the video, subscribe, like, dislike, I don't care, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.